Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate a new capability in the ACE version 13 toolkit, which allows you to manage App Connect container dashboards using the new Container Explorer view. So, the IBM App Connect Enterprise certified container is based on an image of IBM App Connect Enterprise software product, and is offered as an executable package that you can deploy and run within containerized environments. You can deploy the ACE certified container independently into a Red Hat OpenShift container platform or a Kubernetes cluster, or deploy it as part of IBM Cloud Pak for integration. IBM Cloud Pak for integration leverages the ACE certified containers to provide ACE functionality as part of the unified platform for building and managing a wide range of integration solutions. The IBM App Connect Enterprise certified container is built as a Kubernetes application and is delivered as a Kubernetes operator. Operators provide a way to package, deploy, and manage Kubernetes applications. The App Connect operator simplifies the deployment and management of ACE certified containers. The IBM App Connect container dashboard provides a runtime environment for hosting your deployed integrations in production environments. From your App Connect container dashboard instance, you can deploy designer integrations or toolkit integrations to integration runtimes. So in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can access an App Connect container dashboard from the ACE toolkit using the new Container Explorer view. Using this view, you can upload bar files and manage them in the container dashboard. So this is the ACE version 13 toolkit. It is using 13.0.3. And here you can see the usual Integration Explorer in the bottom left-hand corner, which allows you to manage your integration servers, your integration nodes, and external directory vaults. So new in this release, we can now access a App Connect container dashboard using the Container Explorer. So the Container Explorer is right next to the Integration Explorer, and in here you are able to connect to your container dashboards. In order to connect to your container dashboards, you need to right-click on this option here and select Add Connection. So this shows a wizard which prompts you to enter a few bits of information. You need to provide something called an API-based URL and your username and password to access the container dashboard. There's more information about the API-based URL in the link that's provided in the dialog. And if you click on the link, then it opens up the IBM documentation, which describes the API-based URL. And you can access it from your Red Hat OpenShift container platform, where you would have the App Connect operator installed. The API itself is described by an OpenAPI document, which is on the IBM documentation, and it shows how you can access the different resources. There's also an excellent article by Matt Bailey, which describes how to use the API. I'm going to log on to my Red Hat OpenShift container platform, and I'm going to navigate to the API base URL. So I'll show you how to do that using the OpenShift container platform. So I'm going to select operators and then installed operators. I have the IBM App Connect operator installed. For this new capability, you need at least 12.10 of the App Connect operator. So I'm going to click on that, and now if I select dashboards, I have these different dashboards. If I select the dashboard that I want to connect to, I can now see these different links. So the link that is needed is this API link. So if you look at the documentation, you can see that it has a red square around it. This is the link that we need to specify in the wizard. So I'm going to right click on it and do copy link. And now in the toolkit, I'm going to paste that link and I'm going to enter my username and my password. And I'll click finish. So after connecting to the container dashboard, I immediately see the bar files which are currently already uploaded to the container dashboard and the integration runtimes which have already been configured in the container dashboard. So I can see that there are 5 bar files that are already uploaded. I can click on any of them. So for example, this first one, apps-and-policies.bar. I can see the name and the bar URL for it. It's not currently being used by any integration runtime. If I select a different one, for example, transformationmap.bar, I can see it is being used by the quick start integration runtime and the small integration runtime. I can also select any of these integration runtimes, and it gives me information about that integration runtime. So I can see the name, the namespace, the version of ASIP that's being used, and the different bars that are currently being used by the integration runtime. If I select the container dashboard, I can use a menu option to open the web UI for it, and I can see from the web UI the different runtimes that are being used. So I can see the 4 runtimes here, and I can also see the bar files as well. So, as well as seeing the information about the bar files and the integration runtimes, there are a few actions that you can use from this Container Explorer view. So, there are actions which allow you to manage the bar files. So, the first action I'm going to show is how to upload a bar file from your Toolkit workspace to the container dashboard. So, to do this, you select bar files, right-click on it and select Upload Bar. So this shows a list of all the bar files that are in my workspace, and I'm going to upload a bar which is called appwithsharedlibraries.bar. Just to show in the web UI that there are currently 5 bar files, I'm going to select this bar file to upload. I'll click OK. It successfully uploaded it, and I can see that the bar file is being shown in the Container Explorer view. There are now 6 bar files being shown here. Let's flip back to the web UI, and if I refresh this page, I can see that the bar file that I just uploaded, which was App with Shared Libraries, is now showing as well, and there are 6 bar files here showing on this page. So now that I've uploaded it, I can add this bar file to an integration runtime. So notice I have an integration runtime here called Quick Start. It's using 2 bar files at the moment. If I expand the integration runtime, then it'll open up a dialog which shows that it's just fetching the information for the container dashboard. So there are 2 applications that are currently being deployed to that integration runtime, so it's Hello App and Transformation Map. And I can expand each of these to see the artifacts that are part of the application. And the information that is shown for the different artifacts is the same information that you can see in the Integration Explorer. So there are 2 applications here at the moment. I'm just going to right click on this integration runtime and add this bar file. So that should increase the number of bars and shared libraries that are in this integration runtime. Let's just show in the web UI what is in the integration runtime. We'll show the same information. So for Quick Start, it has Hello App and Transformation Map. So I'm going to right click on Quick Start and select Add Bar. I'm going to select the bar that I just uploaded, which was App with Shared Libraries.bar. And click OK. So it's successfully added a bar. I can click OK here and it will refresh the integration runtime. Or optionally, I can actually click cancel and I can then refresh the quick start runtime at a later point when I want to have to manually refresh it. But I'm going to click OK here and it's going to fetch the resources that are being used by this runtime so it can show the information in the Container Explorer. So notice it now shows it's fetching details for 3 applications, previously there were 2, And there are 6 shared libraries, which is going to be shown. So if I open this up, I can see that there are now 3 applications and 6 shared libraries. So this application here, called My App, has been added. If I refresh the web UI and open up Quick Start, I can see these resources are also shown in the web UI. So the toolkit is accurately showing what is on the container dashboard in the same way that the web UI does. So far I've shown how to upload a bar file and add a bar file to the integration runtime. I'm going to show some other actions now so you can remove a bar. So let's remove the bar that I just added to this integration runtime to keep things simple for this demo. So I'm going to select the bar that I just added and I want to remove it from this integration runtime. So integration runtime should go back down to 2 applications after this. So I'll click OK to refresh. It's now fetching the resources. And you can see now that there are 2 applications. So if I expand Quick Start again, it now shows there are 2 applications. If I go back to the web UI, do a refresh, and open up Quick Start, you can see there's 2 applications as well. So I've shown how to upload a bar, add a bar to the integration runtime and remove it from the integration runtime. You can also update a bar file. Let's select a bar to update. So I have this bar file called helloapp.bar, which is being used by Quick Start at the moment. And I have the bar file in my workspace. It currently has 1 application in the bar file. So what I'm going to do is add a second application to this bar file. And select build and save in the bar editor. And if I go back to the manage tab, I can see that this bar file now has 2 applications, Hello App and HTTP input application. So back in Container Explorer now, I'm going to select the bar file, right click and select update. And I want the bar file to be updated in the container dashboard. It's telling me now that after clicking update that the bar is currently being used by the Quick Start integration runtime, and this will cause the Quick Start integration runtime to be updated and then restarted. And I'm just checking if we're sure that we want to continue with the update. So I'm sure, yes, I'd like to continue. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to just select the bar file that I updated in the workspace. So I'm going to click OK there. And it has successfully updated the bar file that's uploaded it to the container dashboard. And I'm going to need to manually refresh in order to see the extra application. Let's just go to the web UI and see if it's updated in the web UI. If I click on Quick Start, I can now see that there are 3 applications. So it has now got HTTP input application. Let's go over back to the toolkit and refresh the integration runtime. So now it's fetching the details. Notice it says it's fetching details for 3 applications. And if I expand it, I can now see that HTTP input application is now being shown underneath the Quick Start integration runtime. So the integration runtime has been modified after the bar file was updated. The final action that I want to show is being able to delete a bar from the container dashboard. So if I select a bar and do right click and do delete, if the bar is being used by a integration runtime, then there will be an error showing that it's currently being used and it cannot be deleted because it's used by an integration runtime. So you can only delete a bar which is not being used by any integration runtime. If I select app with shared libraries.bar, it's not currently being used by any integration runtime, so it'll be safe to delete this. So this is the one that I uploaded originally, so I'll stick with this one. I'll delete the bar, and if I delete the bar, then I'm told that it successfully deleted the bar from the container dashboard. The view is updated here, so you can't see the bar file anymore over here. And if I select bar files, I can see that the app with shared libraries bar files also no longer shown in the web UI. So using the container dashboard view, you're able to manage your bar files and you're able to view information about integration runtimes and see the deployed artifacts as well. So in this video, I've demonstrated a new capability in the ACE version 13 toolkit, which allows you to manage App Connect container dashboards using the new Container Explorer view. I showed how to connect to the container dashboard, and after connecting, you're able to see the bar files and integration runtimes, which are already configured in the container dashboard. I showed the different actions that you're able to do, so you're able to upload a bar and add a bar or remove a bar to or from an integration runtime, and you can update a bar or delete the bar from the container dashboard too.